Hello, it's Dr. Rhonda Johnson. Today is Wednesday, July 22nd, 2020. And today I'm going to be discussing how contagious COVID-19 can be, and also babies and toddlers, how to recognize signs of COVID-19 infection in babies and toddlers. But first, I want to give an example that was provided in one of the medical magazines that I follow every day, about two doctors, the husband and wife couple. They live in Alabama, happened just 2 weeks ago. They had a family gathering. Now, neither of them work they both work in a hospital, but neither of them take care of COVID patients. And they used every precaution available for their picnic. They rented a place on the lake, remote, secluded, and they cleaned everything so that it would be disinfected. And they only had family members, and all the family members had just been as diligent as they were in terms of not going out in crowds, wearing a mask, etc. So they had this family gathering. No one was sick. They were outdoors. They were socially distanced. They had a clean place. They had plenty of hand washing stations. The only thing they didn't do was wear a mask. Now, they had the event on the weekend, and on Monday, one of the doctors started feeling sick, had fever, headache, sore throat, cough, and was diagnosed with COVID-19. And they had all the other family members wait 3 days, get tested, and lo and behold, 8 out of the 11 people who attended that event all tested positive for COVID-19. And the doctors shared their story publicly because they wanted people to understand just how contagious this virus really is. They let their guard down, they said, for one time. And they wanted people to know because people have COVID fatigue. You know, we're all tired of this. We're tired of not having family gatherings. We're not wanting to miss our weddings, reunions, parties, etc. And so people are taking chances. But right now we're in the middle of the pandemic, so the doctors just wanted to share their example and encourage people not to let their guard down. So that's a story, a true story. And you can Google it and find it if you want any more details besides what I've shared. Now, just how bad is our COVID-19 situation currently? Well, we know it must be bad because the president is now talking about it and telling people to wear masks and saying that things are going to get worse before it gets better. But the CDC recently released a report where they believe that, you know, 15 some million people have tested positive for COVID-19. And they believe that the actual infection rate is anywhere between 6 to 24 times higher. Now, they based this on blood samples, for routine blood samples that they tested for antibodies to COVID-19. So I don't know if that's accurate or not, but let's just say the CDC is right. So if 10 more times, they say 6 to 24, so let's do 10. 10 times, we have 15 million people currently with active cases. That would mean there are 150 million people out there with active cases. And then they say as high as 24 times. So let's go with 20. That would mean there would be around 300 million people with active cases right now. So again, most people who have this currently don't know that they have it. They're shedding this virus. And that's what's happening here. That's why the case count keeps going so high every single day. And that's why the hospitals are full of people. And that's why the death count just keeps going up, because we are in the middle of a raging pandemic here in terms of COVID-19. And we just cannot forget that. Regardless if we have COVID fatigue or not, people are starting to do things. And really, they need to pretend like we were back in March and April, and severely restrict their activities to doing just what's necessary. So and wearing their mask at all times, at all times. So it only requires 15 minutes of exposure, and the virus can be shed for 5 days before the first symptom. So don't forget that. So I'm going to switch gears now, and I'm going to talk about babies and toddlers. So the CDC is releasing new information about symptoms in babies and toddlers and how to recognize COVID-19. And again, COVID-19 seems to be less severe in children, but this may not be the same for babies who may be as vulnerable to severe illness as older adults. We just don't know. But we do know that a small number of babies in the United States have died following their diagnosis with COVID-19. So symptoms in babies and toddlers can range anywhere from a cold to a flu to serious respiratory distress. So some of the most common symptoms in babies and toddlers include runny nose, sneezing, cough, and fever. And then changes in their mood or behavior, such as sleeping more or less, changes in the amount of food that they're taking in, diarrhea, and vomiting. And again, dry cough, and symptoms of pneumonia include rapid breathing and shortness of breath. Now, they've said that in babies who develop a serious case of COVID-19, they usually do so within a week of mild symptoms appearing. And severe symptoms in babies include shortness of breath, and a baby may show signs of shortness of breath through rapid breathing, flaring of the nostrils, and looking like they're sucking in the muscles surrounding the rib cage when they're breathing. The muscles are what we call retracting. And also babies can grunt, and that's like making snoring sounds. They grunt a little bit when they're breathing. So again, a baby nor most toddlers cannot verbally tell you what's wrong with them. So parents and caregivers, you just have to have a high index of suspicion, and don't hesitate to take your child to the emergency room. Call ahead. Do not put a mask on a baby or a child under 2 years of age. Do not put a mask on them. Okay, so again, babies and toddlers can get COVID-19. Babies and toddlers can be hospitalized. Babies and toddlers can develop severe respiratory failure and pneumonia and multi-organ failure, just like adults. And sadly, we haven't had that many deaths yet in babies under a year of age, but we have had them. Okay, so that's my information for today. Again, my goal is to have you stay as informed as possible so that you can be knowledgeable. We can do everything in our power to prevent COVID-19 infection in ourselves and in our family members and our neighbors and our relatives. So stay informed, stay alive, stay safe. These views are my own, and have a blessed day.